Any general manager at a club before 6 in the morning must be hands-on.
I think that's routine for Sam.
And does an excellent job. So we appreciate the hospitality here at beautiful Quail Hollow. Ron Soeder heads up our Boys and Girls Clubs. Good to see you this morning.
Yeah, good to see you, Bill. How you doing?
Our tradition continues as you walk over to say hi.
It does. It does. It's going to be a great day. The weather's going to cooperate. The Indians are cooperating, so it's going to be awesome.
I want to talk about Boys and Girls Clubs, and let me start with, I don't want to say the end of your connection with a kid, but let me start with when you go to graduation, when you get to see through college or high school. Chances are your calendar may have a few right now.
Yeah, it has. I have 4 on Saturday. I spent all day at Cleveland State, and it was really thrilling to see the young people that I've met when they were 10, 11, 12, graduate, some from master's degrees, some from regular degrees. Went to one on Saturday at Baldwin Wallace a few weeks ago. She left the next day for Ghana, so it was really cool to see her growth as a teacher.
Wow.
And her, you know, coming from the central neighborhood, grew up in King Kennedy, just to see her take that step to graduation and her next part in life where she's gonna impact children and give back and change lives along the way.
Indians Chairman Paul Dolan spoke at Cleveland State too, right?
He did, yeah. He was the keynote speaker in the morning, and he did a great job.
Boys and Girls Clubs, so we've talked about the graduation point and mm-hmm. the high fives. It's not always that way when you're dealing with young people, right?
You know, it's not. You know, we're in neighborhoods that need us. And so we're in neighborhoods that have high crime rates, high poverty rates. You know, poverty brings its own sort of baggage. You know, we need food. Where are we going to eat? The club provides that safe space where kids can be physically, emotionally, and be surrounded by people that love and care for them, get a meal, have fun. We had so much fun yesterday. We had our 6 to 9-year-old kickball championships. And it was really cool because these kids were just joyful in playing. And so that opportunity to compete and participate is awesome.
A Boys and Girls Club, the mission is to make a connection and try and break a cycle that a family might be in. Is that fair?
Absolutely. You know, our mission is to inspire and enable young people that need us most. And you think about where they live, how they live. 90% of our kids are at or near poverty. But we find that they're creative, they're fun, they smile. They're really bright, and we need to bring that out and help them grow and reach the next step.
Ron Soeder is the president of our Boys and Girls Clubs of Cleveland. To tell you more about how you can help them in different ways involving the Indians coming up. But I don't want to touch on you for a minute. You weren't always doing this, were you?
No, you know, I made wallpaper most of my life. I always joke that uniquely qualifies me for youth development work. But, you know, to me, this was a divine opportunity. I was hired in 48 hours, had no real connection to the club. I raised my kids in Geauga County. I grew up in Westlake. You know, my visit to the city was a game, a meal, a play, where now I'm in neighborhoods that, you see the great people that live there, and we think the club has a role in uplifting and making our neighborhood safer. So me, you know, this is my 14th year, and it's been divine intervention, probably the best thing that's ever happened in my life.
Amen. Cleveland Indians Charities provides educational and recreational opportunity to youth. That really matches up well with the team.
You know, it does, and the Indians have been a donor for more than 25 years, and it's an important part of role. They celebrate with us. You know, they provide a scholarship fund for our youth of the years. Our young man this year, Frank Austin, his dreams to be a NASCAR driver and a high-performance mechanic. He graduates from Max Hayes.
Met him. You brought him up to the station.
He's awesome.
Great guy.
And he's the kind of kid that, you know, without the club, you know, his mom died when he was in 9th grade. He was on his own. Sister had 2 kids, so they were really struggling, and the club played that role for him to have safety, and he found 2 really terrific mentors that changed his trajectory.
If you can help, volunteer, be a part of, get involved in an organization that really makes a difference, I can't think of a better one than Cleve Kids, as they're known as, Boys and Girls Clubs at clevekids.com. Big summer for us with the All-Star Game and All-Star Week. And I saw through the website you got an opportunity to help with
the
charity.
Yeah, you do.
Right?
Yeah. We have, first of all, we have, as part of the legacy projects for the All-Star Game, we're building a teen digital arts suite. So we're going to have a recording studio, podcasting, at East Tech High School. And so the funding from that goes to that. We're going to renovate the Larry Doby playground at King Kennedy. And so the opportunity is we have an all-star raffle where you can win tickets to all the events, including the game, the Home Run Derby, and there's a chance to win that opportunity. The other thing that's happening this summer is our Race for Kids, and Frankie Lindor is our celebrity ambassador. He generally comes down to the zoo on the 22nd of June. That's our biggest fundraiser. And it's really an important part of being involved in the community. And Frank, I can't say enough about Francisco Lindor.
What a guy.
He's not only a 5-tool player, he's a really a committed athlete to his community in Puerto Rico, to the community in Cleveland.
5-2 smile, man.
Oh, man.
5-2 smile.
He's amazing.
Boys and Girls Clubs of Cleveland, one of the beneficiaries of today's event here at Quail Hollow Country Club with the Cleveland Indians Charities. Find out more at clevekids.org about the raffle and the chance to help out with All-Star game and opportunities, again, with Boys and Girls Clubs. Anything else you want to share?
Volunteer opportunities are a great opportunity to get involved. Clevekids.org, there's a volunteer tab. We have a really fun event next week. And actually, GE has donated the lights for the digital arts suites. They're bringing 100 people out to our Broadway club to help clean up the neighborhood, fix up the ball field. We're just going to have a blast with them. And so, you know, there's a great opportunity to volunteer at the clubs.
Shout out to GE, good people. Clevekids.org, Ron Soeder, president of the Boys and Girls Clubs. Thanks, pal.
Bill, thanks for having me.